Hello everyone, I hope you have been doing well, and for those who are new to the channel, we are a Korean-Canadian international couple in our 30s. If you want to know more about our story, you can check our previous videos in the description box below. So in the previous video, it was mentioned that our goal is to attain financial freedom. In order to do so, we need to work very hard so we can either monitor our expenses closely or increase our revenues. Well, speaking of working hard, this is exactly what we are going to see in this video because my husband is a machine. So when he initially told me that he wanted to work multiple jobs, my first reaction was, "Are you crazy? Like, you won't have any life." And I was right, actually, because he doesn't have any. Do you remember when he said that he was working 8 hours a day, so 40 hours a week? Well, turns out he is a freaking liar. Huh? How do you wonder? Well, my husband, he has 3 jobs. We have all heard of cases where a person has to work a second job in order to make ends meet. This is a reality and we should not ignore it. Especially these days, it's very expensive, let's be honest. But our situation is different. The reason that we do that is not because we have trouble paying the bills. All of this money that my husband earns with his other occupations is very much extra money. To put it simple, if you look at this graph, which displays the repartition of the population who earns a certain income, we are about in this one. So our household is part of 15% of the Canadian population. So this is not because of survival. This is purely a drive to make things happen and fast. Because my husband has always said, when you want something to change in your life, you need to desire that change. And the desire have to make you act. Because no one is going to save you except you. All of that may sound good on paper, but how does he actually do it? So Yobo wears many hats, and one of them is being an Amazon warehouse worker. Here you can see the wild worker in his natural habitat. I actually think those carts are kind of cute. As an able-bodied man in good shape and strong health, to repeat his words, is doing a lot of physical work. As you can see, he looks pretty passionate about it. Huh? Every time you order something on Amazon, just think about all the work behind it and the people. But one thing he really likes about this job is how flexible it is. Because when he has nothing special to do during the weekend, he can decide to book a shift. So basically, he uses his free time to solely focus on his goal. This is usually what he does during the afternoon, and this is why I have to take public transportation, because he needs the car. Thank you. But at least he has the stamina for it. So he finishes his work at the warehouse and arrive home before I do, because public transit is Cooking duties are shared in this house. And I'll give that to him. When I first met him, he didn't cook that much. And over time, he really did improve a lot. While I take forever in public transit, he always have time to make dinner ready when I arrive, like a good housewife. Really, it's all about time management. Gosh, I look terrible here.
Hello there.
I remember it was so cold that evening, so this is why my face is red. We have some time to eat together, and this is nice. We talk about our day, or I go on and on about stuff that sometimes he's not even interested about. But yeah, when I'm very passionate about something, I do talk a lot and fast. I realize it is actually very embarrassing to look at myself talk here. I now notice how much I use my hands when I talk. My husband says it's a Quebecois thing, so if there's any Quebec folks watching this right now, I have a question for you. Do you also use your hands a lot when you talk? After dinner, this is actually when he has to go to work. His main work? Because yes, he works night shift. Looking at his conditions here, I always nag him about how bad it is to work in the dark like that. Like, I tell him, it's not good for your eyes to be exposed to the bright screen in the with all the lights out. But he says that, but apparently it's good for him. It's like he is a night bird or a bat. If it was me, I would actually end up asleep in the bed right behind. So long story short, he works 8 p.m. to 4 a.m. But at least for this one, he has to work from home, so he loves it. He says doing IT jobs is something that he's good at, but not necessarily, he does not necessarily loves it. And that's when he realized that doing something you don't love for minimum 20 years is crazy. And that even if the money is good. So this is his work during the week, but wait, there's more. Friday night ain't no rest for the wicked. This is where Yobo works his third job. He makes sushi. After wearing the Amazon worker hat, the IT engineer hat, now he has to wear the sushi maker hat. And even without having any previous sushi making experience, he decided to go for it. Instead of worrying about things like, oh, I've never done it, I won't be good at it, it's not worth it. And it's like when you are applying for jobs and you see one that really interests you and you feel like you will be very good for it. But when you look at the job requirements, it says to have minimum 2 to 3 years of experience. Well, to be honest, you should just apply for it. This will show the employers that you are actually very confident about yourself. And who knows, you might actually score an interview. And I just think that we spend a lot of time worrying about things that have not happened or might actually not even happen. And we have to instead, you know, just kick ourselves in the butt. Like I have mentioned in my personal video, going out of your comfort zone. Because the payback will be greater than if you are not trying at all. Finally, it's the weekend. He can finally breathe just a bit. And yes, I have been questioning him if he is tired. And of course, he told me that he is. Physically, he is tired, but mentally, I have never seen him better. Compared to when he had his depression, he is way up here. So yes, he is intense. But as they say, if you want an extraordinary life, you can't live like an ordinary person. He has been told that while doing all of that, it's still possible to keep things balanced. But actually, if he does that, it will take way, way longer for him to attain his goal. Say his goal, but it is actually our goal. Because you know, it's like workout. If you want results very fast, you have to put the work into it and, you know, maybe go at a more intense pace. I am not a professional trainer or anything. I'm just trying to make a metaphor, okay? And in his case, while he's being intense, well, the payout is real. I know he is a man of his words because when he said that he was going to make our money work for us, well, it looks actually very promising. Yeah, I've had people ask me, what about you? Are you happy in that? Because let's be honest, with this rhythm of life, of course I do not spend as much time with him than before. To give you an honest answer, I'm gonna be very transparent with you all. Yes, I'm still very happy because honestly, I prefer to see my husband being maybe more tired, but at least he is not depressed compared to before, maybe less tired, but I could see that it was not going well, you know. The thing is, I'm actually a very independent person, so it's okay for me to not be all the time with him. Actually, I'm pretty satisfied to have time with myself that I can put into my personal projects. For example, I take this time to draw or continue to learn Korean. And also soon I will have to go back to university online. I'm taking some courses in order to pass a certification. So yes, I'm going to be very, very busy. And yes, well, those little projects of mine are also going to contribute to reach our goal because these will unlock me new opportunities. So in the end, seeing my husband being motivated like that, well, actually makes me very happy. Because if he is happy, well, I am too. So I really do hope that if you that is watching right now, if you are holding back to accomplish something, that you will eventually overcome your fear. Of course, if said thing is not life-threatening or hurting anybody. So yes, this is about how my husband works to attain this goal and why he has 3 jobs. Counting YouTube, now it's 4. And of course, his case is only one example because everybody is different and not everyone have the same life circumstances. And you that is watching, are you working toward a goal right now? Because we would love to hear about it in the comment. Or should I still read about it? See you in the next video. Au revoir.